Hello guys, welcome back to another video. And today we're in Santa Cruz de la Sierra in Bolivia. And I'm here with my two friends. One of them is now showing me, today is the day of liberty. No, not day of liberty. Today they have like a free day, like a holiday day. And we're going to visit something and we just quickly saw this on the street. So check this out. ¿Esa es la cultura de cómo se llama?
Lado antiplánico de Bolivia.
¿La?
Zona antiplánica de Bolivia.
Antiplánica.
Yes, yes.
You see, they're all dancing here. Yeah, let's go. So, I'm with two friends. We were together yesterday. The other friend is waiting in the car right now. And they're super hungover from yesterday. They don't sleep, nothing. And yeah guys, so Santa Cruz de la Sierra, I'm already here for 6 days. Man, I hope it's not too loud. I'm already here for like 6 days, making my friends as always. Let's go and see and check this out here. With some beer. The Huari. Finally back filming, guys. It's been a long time.
This is the flag of Santa Cruz, the green, white, green.
No tiene bandera, pero es igual de la zona antiplánica.
Eso es de la
paz. La paz. La paz.
Seems to be a cool event here. Small beats.
China, son el espectáculo, las más bonitas de las danzas.
Damn. Really, me gusta aquí. Muy lindo.
Está, es un poquitito, sabe ser.
Pero es como, parece como carnaval.
Ah, este chiquitingo.
Sí, pero el espíritu es como carnaval.
Okay, sí. El de febrero, sí. El de febrero es mucho más grande, lo duro,
¿Hay así también?
Sí, pero no.
Mucho
20
más
veces más grande.
Ah, okay.
Y más frío.
¿Más frío?
Sí, eso es lo malo.
So guys, today's plan is we're going to visit sand dunes outside of the city. I will give you on another day a day like a city trip around Santa Cruz, but for now on we're going to visit the desert just 30 minutes away from the city.
Okay, vamos.
Vamos. ¿Por qué podemos entrar en la media?
Sí, puedes entrar, o sea, ¿sabes? Entonces,
pero no
hay. Hacer una abeja. ¡Wow!
Me gusta que es como contradicción.
Sí, ya hay nadie, amor, no se están pensando.
The girl is here.
Well, I was not expecting to see something like this today. This is cool.
¿Y tú hablas inglés también, no?
So-so.
Estoy
aprendiendo.
All right. So, our friend is waiting in the car. And actually, the friend we're going to see right now in the car is the one I got to know first. I was with her yesterday the whole night and day. We were drinking a lot, and so, long story short, she forgot her phone in the taxi, and we were hunting it the whole night, like 5 hours. But now she finally got it. Guys, there's another thing I want to show you, or another story I want to tell you. When I entered Bolivia with my bike, the first thing that I recognized was like many men had something like a disease here on their cheek, and I was thinking like, what the fuck is going on? Why is everyone having like some problems with their teeth or something like that? And after the like 20th person I saw, I was like asking one guy, what is that? And he's like, I'm chewing coca, you know, like the coca leaves, the leaves that are making the cocaine from. And 1 second. Aquí se espera. ¡Qué bonito! ¡Vamos, sí, vamos!
Ya vamos.
Okay, so now there's a little bit more quiet. So I was sleeping in one hotel between the border of Brazil and... between the border of Brazil and here, Santa Cruz. And so I asked one guy, what's that? What's that?
¿Qué hizo? ¿Qué es eso?
¿Querés?
No, solo quiero saber.
Es un refresco típico de Santa Cruz, es con maíz.
¿Con maíz?
Sí.
Somo.
Somo es así, chicha somo.
¿Es maíz?
Maíz cocido, maíz con canela y clavo,
okay,
de olor. Gracias.
La próxima vez voy
así
a probar.
Como refresco, ¿no?
Ah, ok.
¿A probar el
frío?
Claro, frío.
Ah, ok.
¿A probar el mocochinchi?
¿Puedo ver adentro? Muy bien, gracias. Ciao.
So, and I was in this city. Let's say hi to our other friend.
Hola.
Okay, so, oh, the dog is here. Okay, we'll see us later because I cannot film here with the music. Okay, so, where are we going?
Lomas de Arena.
Lomas de Arena. Now we have a little bit less noise because it was really loud there. mucho ruido.
Mucho ruido.
Ah, sí.
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 And the
lomas
de arena is like sand dunes, no?
Yeah.
It's like a little. Is Santa Cruz de la Sierra named after this? Because Sierra is.
Nothing to do with that.
Why
it has been named Santa Cruz de la Sierra? I need to study more. But
you know everything. No, yeah. But you don't know that.
To do with the dance. And you can do sandboard, and there's a little lake, so it's a good place to see the sunset.
And we're going to see the sunset now. We have our swimming stuff here. Swimming stuff. ¿Dónde es tu...?
En el backpack.
Ah, okay. En el backpack.
And...
But we need... I read in the internet that you need like a four times four car to go there, right?
Yes, exactly.
That's why we don't go with the bike.
Yeah, exactly, because it's like kind of challenging.
Yeah, I don't want to be stuck there with my bike.
Road.
So, I want to show them the coca. You know, I was in this city, and in the next morning, I went to one guy that put some air in my tire because I saw it.
And se bolivianiza aquí el amigo.
¿Cómo se llama aquí?
Coca.
Pero no hay otro nombre.
Bolear.
Bolear.
Ah, bolear.
So they call it here bolear. I'll show you how it's looking from the inside. Actually, I'll take some now.
Oh no, delicious. No.
I like.
No.
I think it's really delicious. It's like tea. And
tiene sabor.
And
no, yeah, tiene sabor a coca.
Yeah,
pues.
It smells like, for me it smells like tea. And then you put it like here.
Este es épico, dije, es el primero que conozco.
Oh my god. And then you let it sink in, you know. And the people here, who are the most people that use it normally?
The workers, the security guards. Because it gives you a lot of energy, the guys who work in the petroleum industry as well, because they don't sleep very well. But it's a boost of energy. It is said that it's actually good for your pressure, for your...
Sugar. But not good for the blood pressure, you told me yesterday, right?
That's what I meant.
And man, this guy gave me this whole bag, it was filled. I just wanted to try one mouth, and he like, take this whole bag. But she showed me yesterday how it's prepared, and then she was like, you'll probably not eat it if you know how it is prepared, and...
Yeah, it's not very hygienic.
Yeah, I'm wondering, I don't even want to look at exactly, like, I don't want to find any insects or some, you know?
Insects is not the problem, the problem is that they
step on
it. On them with no hygiene.
With
hygiene.
I don't know.
No hygiene.
I don't know. Hygienicas.
Yeah.
But it smells like tea. And I tried it. I eat it. Well, you don't eat it. You take it out after how long normally?
2 hours, I think.
2 hours? I could not take it so long. Normally I put it out like after 30 minutes.
¿Cuánto tiempo le das al lady? 2 horas? ¿Quién?
How?
I have no idea. No, seriously. I thought that it was like 2 hours.
I think they put always more inside, no?
Okay.
Because the people I saw, they have like this. And, oh my god. And here it's not illegal, it's legal here. Also in Peru and where else? I think only in Peru.
In Peru I saw it, like in the front.
Because in Colombia this is not legal, in Brazil it is not legal. Argentina probably neither. So,
it's a leaf, you know? I don't know if... Oh, of course, if it's mixed with other stuff,
then you get
illegal,
the cocaine.
But
yeah.
Just the leaf, no problem.
But actually, it makes sense that it's legal. I mean, it's just a leaf. And for me, I think it's just really special that you can just take it because
it's very powerful.
Yeah, it makes you.
You cannot sleep all day, and you are completely full of energy with that.
You
thing.
Needed this yesterday.
Yeah, I need it now, actually. No way.
How long do we have to drive?
15 minutes.
What are all the trucks doing here? So much gas, so much.
It's not. It's gasolina.
Yeah, and when I am driving.
Refinería.
Ah, there's a
la refinería es
yeah.
Gasolina, no? Sí, eso.
So I will have to make you guys another video of how the Santa Cruz city actually looks. But today we're finally doing the first
somos?
Video.
¿Ah? Somos, viste, ¿no? Chicha, somos.
Ajá, yo quiero probar todo.
Ah, ok.
Hay que llevarlo al aljibe a que pruebe y ahí hace un video de todo lo típico.
Sí, vamos a hacer un video de, probar todas las comidas.
De
sí.
Santa Cruz. Bien.
Hay sí, mucho, ¿no?
En Río Río Pera ahí hay caballitos.
I don't want to do more of this stuff. It's like two.
Dale.
Then it looks like this. And, yeah, so. I don't know, like, I kind of get like, after some time having it inside.
Is it strong?
Yeah, it's strong, but it smells like tea, that's good, you know, it's not as, for me it doesn't have a, like a bad taste, so I think it's good for driving my motorcycle, so maybe I will get myself another bag.
I recommend it, it's good. Because it's dangerous if you ride a bike at night, you know?
So but
you,
I never ride a bike at night. It's too dangerous.
Okay.
My parents always like, if there comes one animal in front of you, we have to pick you up as a cripple. And yeah. I will take my sunglasses.
Okay.
No, it's okay. I thought there's no sun.
No sun at all. We will manage to see the sunset somehow.
So guys, the drive here from the Brazilian border. Actually, I just drove over the border and they didn't give me any stamp. So when I wanted to check in the hotel, they were like, where's your stamp? I'm like, well, they didn't ask me for nothing. I just drove over the border and good. Because I read that you need like an insurance for your bike and I didn't want to do that. Do you think you need an insurance here for bikes?
A permission. Yeah, permission, I heard. It's pretty cheap, like,
but some
50 Bs is like, not even $10.
Some
and you need to have the permission.
Some police stopped me, you know, and they were like, I showed them my.
They are stopping all of the delivery guys.
Yeah,
asking for the permission.
Yeah.
And the permission, you have to pay 50 Bs, which is less than $10. But if you don't pay, the fine is like $15.
$15.
Yeah. I heard. I was told.
But yeah, so they checked all my stuff and. He even saw that the stamp was missing, like in my passport. But I think they were just too lazy to actually do something, because I didn't have the stuff that is required to enter. But I mean, even the police is chewing on the coca, so that says a lot, I think. But the drive was really nice. Maybe I will put some. I'm actually planning on doing like a video. Like in a time lapse from driving to Brazil, from Brazil to Colombia in once, but this will be on a later time, I guess. So guys, I'm going in the back to film and show you guys how it's looking here. We're in the middle of the nothing and well, I hope I don't fall now. Let's hold myself here a little bit. Ooh. So yeah, what I was about to say before, guys, I don't remember, but she is actually a really good guide. I had a lot of fun with her yesterday. Oh my god, it's bumping around here. And she she knows a lot about
Hold very tight, please.
Yes, I'm holding tight.
I'm kind of scared.
No, don't worry. Yeah, I'm holding. Okay, I'm better sitting down here. So, she was a very good guide for me yesterday and showed me a lot of stuff. And because this is my, you know guys, I'm always doing the same. I arrive at one place, then I stay for 5 days or some to get to know the people. And then I can finally make the plans, make the videos. Because when you're like in a place and you're just like there for 2-3 days, then you have to leave, you don't really get to know the locals. And that's because I'm normally not staying in hostels, because I don't like to be with other gringos. I need to make friends first, you know, and friends you don't make on your first or second day, especially if you tell them you're leaving in the next day. Wow, it's so beautiful here, guys. And yeah, they're really cool people here I'm with now. On the weekend I'm going with some other girl. I'm going to a place like 3 hours away from here that everyone is talking about, and it seems to be really nice. And I rented like a little house there for 2 nights, and I already met her. And a funny story, you know, I wanted to meet her, and then she was like, yeah, we should go to a concert together. And I was like, yeah, for sure, let's go. And then when we met, she was like, okay, let's go. And I was like, where's the concert? She's like, yeah, in the church. And I'm like, what in the church? You're taking me to the church? And she's like, yeah, yeah, because we're going to a concert. And I'm like, didn't you tell me we're going to a rock concert? And she was like, no, I didn't say rock, I said baroque. So like with the violins and the piano and everything like that. But then we didn't go because she didn't have a good time management. So we just bought a bottle of wine and went to my apartment. And had a good time there. So the next video you will see, it will be probably with her. And now I think we have to pay. It seems more difficult to ride like on the back on the car than I was thinking. And yeah, so this is the Bolivian experience, guys. The Bolivian coca sand dunes wildness experience.
Vamos.
Tuve sus articulaciones, viejita. Estaba en la loma de arena.
Wow, check this out, guys. It's beautiful here. So close to the city. Wow. Yeah.
¿No querías agarrar tu chinela?
No. Así.
Damn, guys. It's crazy here. Whoa. And everyone's here passed us with like the four times four little quads for the sand, you know?
Vamos, Lenín!
Vamos!
Los dos, los
Vamos!
Antes que yo checa, ¿no? Dame la cerveza para que puedas ver bien. Dale.
Gracias.
Porque aquí de noche no se va a ver nada.
That looks like something really fun. Quiero ir con uno de esos.
¡Ah, dile! Sí. ¡Son tan amable! Te van a dejar subir. Que pase otra vez, te lo vamos a parar. ¿Ok?
Ajá. Pero hay atardecer.
¡Uy, la más feliz! La cachorrita.
No. El perrito.
¿Quieres dejar algo aquí? Ok. Las
cosas.
Un tipo que ¿sabes lo que falta acá?
¿Qué?
De eso.
Ah, para el snowboard.
Ay, sí.
Ah, sí.
¿Viste? Tablas, ¿no ves? Las tablas para bajar.
Ajá.
Wow. Ay, en Perú eso.
Sí, en Perú. O acá China o algo, ¿no?
¡Ay, sí!
¡Ah! ¡Qué lindo aquí!
Sí. Está fresquito, o sea, no hay sol. Que te queme.
Pero mejor con sol.
Para vos, claro, te das un full bronceado, ¿no? Para mí, no.
¡Wow!
Algo del atardecer.
Sí. Sí.
Moni, ¿y al otro lado está el agua ese chiquitito?
No, más allá.
Ah.
¿Querés ir a ver?
Un descanso. Me agoté, la verdad.
Guys, this is beautiful, man.
¿Arriba?
Ajá, claro.
Gaza. Mamá, ayuda. Lo más difícil es subir.
Ya vamos, vamos.
Dale, corre.
A su mami,
no
más le hace
caso.
Okay.
Vamos,
gordita.
Yo. Wow. I think this is one of the most beautiful places I've been in South America. Yeah. Really beautiful. How is this even possible? There's just sand dunes.
No idea, I'm going to study. But right now the lake is a little bit dry.
But there must have been like a sea here or something, no?
I have no idea.
What is that? Oh, I want to see what's coming here. I feel like a little child. I got sand in my eyes. Oh, damn. Wow. Oh my God, guys. What is this beautiful place? Oh, it's looking so magical with the sand that's like floating over the ground. We have a little photo session here.
Zapatos después, llave, una llave. Minuta, todo de arena.
She's just leaving her stuff here, man, like yesterday when she forgot her phone.
Vale.
Guys, 10 out of 10 experience. If you ever come to Bolivia, Santa Cruz, Loras de Arena. And you know what is really special here in Santa Cruz? No other tourists. I've never seen one tourist in 6 days that I'm here. No tourists. That's the first time in all South of America that there were no tourists. And she dipped my camera in the sand, man. What is that? Now it's full of sand.
Bienvenido a Bolivia.
Gracias.
Este es un pequeñito pedacito de lo que es Bolivia. Me falta mucho más que conocer Samaipata, Salar de Uyuni, Toro Toro.
Wow, here it's going down. Sí, falta mucho.
Sí, es profundo.
Sí, es profundo. Yo pensé que iba a revelar igual que vos.
No, sí.
¿Quieres que te grabe?
Oh, it's like slick sand. Oh. Wow. Nice Bolivia, nice Bolivia. Vamos, 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 vamos. Vale la pena visitar Bolivia. What is that? Mira, Peggy, Peggy, Peggy. I can't believe that so close to city there's such a nice natural sand dunes. Man, beautiful. I kind of just want to like walk as far as I can.
People?
Let's go, correct? People.
Okay.
Let's go, people. Let's go, guys.
Let's go, guy. Guy es chico.
No, guys. Sí, guy es un chico, pero guys es para todos. Goodbye. All right, guys. So this will be the end of the video. I hope you like it. Come to Bolivia. Bolivia is really beautiful. Something else to say?
Enjoy Bolivia.
Enjoy Bolivia. ¿Y tú tienes algo para decir?
Que les hago la invitación para que vengan a mi país, Bolivia, que es hermoso. Por favor, visítenos. Bye.
Goodbye, guys. I love you all. Hello, my friends. Welcome back to the channel. Today we have a super cool, nice restaurant. What is the name of the restaurant?
El Aljibe.
El Aljibe.
And typical.
We're trying typical food here with my two friends, Monica and Lady. Now, unfortunately, we already started to eat, but let's show you guys what's left.
Okay, so here we have it's called keperi, which is a meat that has been boiled for like too many hours, more than 24 hours. It's so delicious. And this is a typical rice here in Santa Cruz, which is majadito. Majadito, what is left. So it's usually with an egg, with the banana fried banana, and a little bit of rice and dried
huevo.
And dry meat. You know, this is it. And mocochinchi, which is a beverage from dried peach.
Here you guys have inside a little peach, and it's actually really good. I was already chewing on one and almost biting my how is it called, diente, my teeth off. So what is the plan of today? We're going to visit her best friend.
Yeah, my best friend's always a gym, so it's the anniversary of the gym. So he's throwing a party, so we're going to party a little bit.
We're going to party a little bit here with lady also. ¿Cómo estás?
Hello, ¿qué tal, chicos?
You know, this meat is like when you have a Croatian grandma from the Slavic countries. They make similar meat like this. It's also cooked in a soup.
No, it's not in a soup, it's like boiled, or it could be as well in oven.
In an oven, okay.
For too many hours,
okay. Let's go.
Enjoy.
Let's eat.
Okay.